Kasi I have two kids now. One is a toddler, one's a baby pa talaga. And guarding your energy is so important. Kasi I noticed with my firstborn, because nga una, I kind of didn't know what I was doing. I was more stressed. And the baby was fussier. Versus when I gave birth to my second, kahit medyo alam mo na, so I was a bit more calm. And the baby's demeanor is also more calm. So I've been reading up about that. Parang whatever your energy is around your children, they pick that up. So for me, I feel it's so important to always try to be, yun nga, more calm, more gentle, more loving. Kasi the way we show that to them, that's how they'll be to other people also. Eh. Like I notice, lalo na toddler, they kind of echo what you do. So how I am to my child, that's how she is to her baby sister or to others. So if we raise them in a, yun nga, kinder, gentler way, they will tend to be like that to others also. So yeah, to guard your energy, I think first and foremost.
To be very honest, that's actually something that my wife helps me with, because my wife is the one who's very parang siya yung naaawa kay Leia. Ako yung medyo nag-i-enforce ng rules. But you know, it's a good thing, that good point that she brought up, was that they do mimic the stuff that we do at home. And that's one thing that really stopped me from, you know, spanking or being or raising my voice at her, kasi ayoko talagang ayokong isipin niya na okay lang yung gawin sa ibang tao. And I my biggest fear all the time, every time, you know, she plays around with other children, is that I don't want her to be hitting other kids. I want her to be sharing with other children. So that's something that I always keep in mind every time na nagtatantrum or umiiyak or you know, she breaks something in the house. That's the first thing that pops in my head, so that it changes my approach on how to enforce the rules.
So another topic mentioned a while ago was connectivity. So can you share with us what do you do to make sure you bond with your kids or child despite your busy schedules? Because the thing of you have busy schedules, can you share what you do or your time management skills?
Less sleep. I try to spend at least sana 2 hours a day, an hour in the morning, an hour at night, playing with her. Because obviously yung pag naliligo siya or yung reading niya, studying when she goes to class and all that, her mom is the one who has the time to be able to do that with her. So I'm very conscious of the fact that I don't have the same amount of time with her. And I do notice that when it comes to playing, that's the only time na hinahanap niya talaga ako. And I wanna build that relationship I have with her. So I make it a point na, you know, when she wakes up in the morning, kahit na may trabaho ako, kahit na may mga emails na kailangan isend, I put all of that, that's all secondary to me. The most important really is for me to be able to play with her, so that we develop the trust, we develop that relationship where she knows that I'm not just her dad, I'm also her friend.
Mom, we give birth to them, we breastfeed them, so there's already that instant connection that you create. But as they grow older, I feel like, lalo na now, we're always on our phones. Home time as much as possible, I try to stay away from my phone kasi they feel it, they know it. At saka siya, bawal siya manood, bakit ako, I'm on my phone. So little things like that when I'm at home, I try as much as possible that I play full attention sa kanya. Until now, I bring my daughter to school, hatid sundo, put her to sleep. Basta I'm home, everything that can be done, I'll try to do myself. They don't forget moments like that. Eh. Kids are very, very sharp. They really appreciate the little things like that. Yung parang randomly at the end, they'll hug you. Or I love you. Parang out of nowhere, and you're like, okay.
You did a good job.
Okay, good job.
Like, kunwari, with how they took care of you when you were young.
Oh, me, I have two now. So my issue now is sharing toys. So the baby will get a toy and the auntie will be like, "That's mine." But you know, it's very normal. So one thing I said to my child na parang, "Uy, I sound like my mom," is my mom always used to tell us, "Okay, if you don't want, share your toys to your baby sister, because if you share your toys, we'll give you more toys. If you don't know how to share your toys, sorry, we'll just give your toys away to other kids." Parang ganun. It was more of a, and she's like, "Okay."
But you were so, the youngest, no? So
I was the youngest.
Beneficiary of all
yes,
that.
But now I hear what my mom would tell me. I tell my daughter, and I'm like, I think we tend to copy our parents' style and put our own twist into it.
Also had the same situation as me right now with Leia. It was always, we were always spending time with our mom because my dad was always busy with his tours. He was always doing concerts. But the one thing that the one activity that we always did together was he used to collect G.I. Joes and Star Wars figures, and he would play with me, and as early as my first memories growing up, I always remembered that when he would come home, he would open his box of G.I. Joes and Star Wars, and then we would just play the whole night in his room. So that's something that some of those Star Wars toys and those G.I. Joes I still have today, and we play with them. We play with the same stuff that my dad and I used to play with. So, and again, like I mentioned a while ago, we don't also limit her to toys that are yung parang stereotypically for girls or for boys. We make her, she loves playing with cars. She loves Spider-Man, but she loves Barbie. She loves cooking, but we just wanted na, you know, for her to not sort of be boxed in by you know, oh, pink is for girls and blue is for boys. She loves blue. She loves green, so you know that's the kind of environment that we want her to grow up in. Where?
How do you make sure, aside from play, that she explores her environment or surroundings at a safe distance?
Because it's important. Our whole house, except for my den, our whole house is Leia proof. I mean, like she climbs everything. Yes.
Hi, you want a pillow?
Okay, you know we're talking about you, huh? No, we just made sure that everything is safe. All our outlets are covered. All our extension cords, when they're not being used, are unplugged. Everything's turned off. We just made sure that she can go anywhere in the house and like she won't be able to pull a knife or bite on a cable or climb something dangerous. There are times where she will still, you know, find something, but I just felt that for our peace of mind, if we just adjusted everything, it would just let us sleep better at night.
Even if you're a parent, you're a partner first, and when the kids grow up, it's gonna be you and your partner. You have to make sure that you're still in love with each other and on the same page. So that's something my husband and I like to guard. So I guess for us, we don't go on a date night as much as we'd want to because we have very small children. But we're very aware that at least for these few years, it's automatic. Your priority will be your child. So we're just aware of that. We're not as matangpuin to each other when it comes to time with each other. We know that this is a phase, and when they're mga 5 years old, they won't need us anymore. So we're just kumbaga riding it right now. And the few times na kaya mag-movie or dinner out, we try to make it. When our kids were born, I was the disciplinarian, I was the strict one. And my husband was the good, whatever you want. I mean, that's not always the case. Sometimes it's the other way around. But it organically happened. I think parang nagtatsahan kami. When I saw that he couldn't rate, konting iyak lang ng daughter namin, bibigay na siya. Siguro I took on the role na okay, ako yung disciplinarian. But your wife?
I'm the disciplinarian. My parents kasi told me also na, you know, do whatever I want. I did whatever I wanted. So I'm kind of traumatized by my own, like I wasn't a very nice kid. So I think when you're not a nice kid growing up, you're a little, naturally you become a little stricter because you know na when I was young, gago.